Fanatics turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Dire team pick.
Slada.
Fanatics turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Life stealer.
Fanatics turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Dire team ban.
What? I'm here. Oh, nice.
10 seconds remaining.
That's fine. Starter Lifestealer. You ready for another Starter Lifestealer?
Reserve time. Fanatics turn to ban.
That's actually genius. How do you come up with these strategies?
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
I see the synergy. It's all physical. It might even help you do Roshan. I honestly think that a lot of the issues that Fnatic had last game actually could be attributed to the itemization. I actually feel like the itemization should have been, or could have been, a little better. No. I think it's for a lot of the heroes on their team. For example, Juggernaut, I think after his laning phase, he should have went for Manta into Maelstrom. He should have went to Shadow Blade, because he went for a fighting build when he was so far behind. It just didn't really do anything. I think he should have just played a little more greedily and went for a farming build instead.
10 seconds remaining.
No, Manta is fine, but I mean, like, after that. He went for Blink and Diffusal Blade when he could have went for Manta into Maelstrom, for example. And then Underlord, he went for Guardian Greaves, Force Staff, and then Veil. I think Veil was actually okay, but then he went for, was it Lotus? Maybe it was the Veil that was the issue. I think everything else is actually okay.
Fanatics turn to pick.
And then, yeah.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
He managed to farm like
reserve time
so much because of that, and it paid off. He made it a lot happen for his team.
Ursa Warrior.
Dire team pick.
All right, they're going to go straight for the Ursa. Deal with his lifestealer. I think this might be a little bit too early for this pick.
10 seconds remaining.
Well, we'll see how GeekFam deals with this. I think you just remaining. Pick something that can actually deal with the Ursa, and you just have the Sardar and lifestealer deal with everyone else.
Fanatics turn to pick.
I'm actually really surprised that Shadow Demon hasn't been picked up.
10 seconds remaining.
That would be a good hero to deal with Ursa.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, there's always the potential for this to be a support starter at the end of the day. So we'll just have to see what they end up picking up. That's not bad. I know it's actually pretty good.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Dire team pick.
Well, they don't have to worry about the Rubik either. They think GeekFam could probably just run this as Slaughter support. Maybe just. Oh, Bounty Hunter. I was gonna say too, like they kind of need a Rodgi hero. He plays all these different heroes that are just like always up in the enemy's base and getting information, just doing his own thing.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
I don't think it was too bad. It was just the situation he was put in was like really, really difficult to deal with.
Dire team ban.
It's because Velo was sacrificed and he pretty much soaked in the lane while standing invis. And he got that one kill as well.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
A little.
Dire team pick.
It's also kind of risky in lane too. I think Ursa actually like easily kill Storm in lane with a Rubik rotation. So you have to look out for that too.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Kind of hard to say what would be good here. Maybe they should just pick something up that can actually kite the Ursa and deal with Enigma. Puck is actually not bad. The Puck is actually okay. I would say Viper, but I don't know. I don't know if Teehee plays that hero. After looking at his hero pool, I don't think it's like the kind of hero he would play. I think Magnus would have a very difficult game here if he if they went for it. All right, they just go for the Shadow Fiend. Is he a Queen of Pain? There's a Queen of Pain game. This is probably it.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Didn't they end up winning that game, though? Of pain. Oh, they won Queen of Pain. Oh, no, they lost. I remember now. Yeah, yeah. And then he had Refresher, and he didn't have enough mana to refresh. I remember that. So the way they can actually play this is you could safe lane your Slardar to deal with the Underlord, I believe, and Lifestealer and Witch Doctor can actually lane against Rubick or
something. 5 seconds remaining.
All right, early TP from Ohio. It's gonna get that safe prepare ward. So I guess battle. They, yeah, they're ready for this. No, never mind. Psionics is just heading top lane. I wonder if they'll transition or change lanes if they see who's up here. But I really think they should just pressure the safe lane with the Lifestealer and Witch Doctor.
I mean, I think it's okay too, just to like do a standard laning scenario. Because I feel like they could actually harass Ohio quite a bit. They won't kill him or anything, but... Former teammates, you know, giving good luck to each other.
I've seen Bushi play mid for the most part, but it seems like they're just content with staying on these roles.
I think it's actually hero-dependent. If they...
That's what I thought too, but it seems like they're just... staying with Mushi on carry and baited on the mid because Bob is definitely one of Mushi's heroes and he's not playing it.
Oh, you're right. And yeah, he's playing Ursa instead.
It doesn't get any more hero dependent than that.
That's true. Well, it won't be the first time for Fnatic to be switching roles. So now, when you're not doing too well, definitely could switch things up. Battle begins. Raji's absolutely out of mana already, but I guess you could always just go back to your base and pop a shrine and walk back out.
Interesting to see Fnatic so easily giving up the runes like that.
Oh, Raji's messing up.
Here to ruin the Enigma's day.
Well, he's not actually... Okay, now he needs to go back and block it. But Enigma kind of expects it already, and now he actually goes up top. You do the jungle. Ooh, I like this. Do you see he denied a set of creeps on the mid lane and denied one on the top? And had just enough cooldown to get both denies. Normally, you just get one deny and not worry too much about it. But now he's able to do both. Needs to micro his Eidolon, so there you go.
Don't worry, that's why he's a professional.
Alright. I'm sure you could micro Eidolons. I believe in you, Steven.
Yeah, debatable.
Alright, here comes Raji. If he gets the last hit on this Walken, but... Oh, again, Febby just eating the range creep from Ohio Sling. I mean, that's gotta be annoying for Geek Fan.
I'm really surprised that Rodgy has used up all of his mana. This is actually really, really bad for him.
Oh, not if he gets us last hit! No, he didn't. I mean, I don't think he dies here or anything.
He's not really able to accomplish much, though. Oh, Febby?
Yo, the Sentry Ward, just outside of range. Raji! Oh,
if he micros this, he's actually gonna kill him.
No, he's got one more. I mean, there's no dust or anything. Oh, there's a Sentry.
No, he's Sentry. He was baiting him the whole time. The
tables turn. Alright.
I haven't seen a suicide in a very long time.
That's a level 6 suicide. Or rather, you have the level 6 respawn time, so it's gonna be a while until he's alive.
Illusion. Not too much happening now. Febby tries to go for the D ward and look at that ward.
No, he just dropped that ward to scare away the bounty. Wasn't really for the D ward, but yeah, it's a bit outside. But he won't know this until the 3 minute rolls around.
Mushi is having a really rough time. The Slardar is single-handedly just 1v2ing this lane.
Yeah. I mean, at the same time, Ohio is also 1v2ing up top, so it's okay.
I think Velo is getting more out of his lane, though. Because Ohio isn't really able to farm, whereas Velo actually is getting farmed.
Why are they playing so passive versus the Slaughter? I feel like ADTR could be a little bit more aggressive. Okay, maybe they're expecting this. Raji's gonna take a ton of damage. The Fable and the right clicks. First blood goes to ADTR. Well then.
I think they just don't even want to bother wasting too many resources dealing with Velo. Because he's way harder to kill. I mean, there's actually like no way to kill him, right? Because he just stunned after the lift.
I don't think you have to kill him, right? You just like put up the red paws and run at him. Don't let him CS. Like conversely, I think the
Mushi
top lane...
Mushi has been doing that, hasn't he?
I mean, every time I look at Velo, he's the 4 HP. He is out of regen, so I guess they've been harassing him a little bit. Like conversely, mid-lane. I feel like Ohio could be zoned out more.
Rocky might get a kill here. He just used Blink. This should be a kill on the Quap.
Scream? Dagger? Yeah, he knows he's dead, so he's trading. Teehee. Pretty big. ADTR is gonna port out. No bash. By the way, I don't think we've seen a Shadow Fiend lose yet, right? Here at the sea. Qualifiers. Or if he...
You're gonna have to pull up some statistic for that, because I don't actually...
Well, definitely today he has not lost yet, right? And is this like the third or fourth Shadow Fiend game?
Shadow Fiend is actually really strong in this patch again.
Yeah.
He has so many resources to work with. Shrines enables him.
The Talons are good.
Yeah.
Sentry Ward gets dropped here, and now he needs to blink back. Okay, Raji might be in a little bit of trouble. Tower focusing on him as well. Nice toss back here and faded.
Oh! Ooh.
Needs to juke that raise. Teehee's really going for it. And now he takes like 4 tower shots. ADTR still going for the right click.
Is he...
Okay,
oh,
nice.
Here we go. He has so many wall charges.
Yo.
Really well played from Teehee.
I mean, everyone overcommitting longer than they should, right? I think Teehee overcommitted, but then Rubick is like, okay, I'm gonna hit you.
I was underestimating that raise. You don't mess with the Shadow Fiend like that in the early game.
Cyanix just driving Ohio away.
So overall, I'd say that... Oh, bottom lane?
Mushi's gonna get crushed under the tower? Down. Is there mana? There is no
mana.
No mana. Ooh, he's just like one hit away.
That was really close.
Yeah. Life of Ursa, always one hit away.
Velo's gonna hit level 5 here. He's doing pretty good here. No more shrine for him though.
Yeah, it's gonna probably just sprint back to base and use that.
He's got 1,000 gold already. Kind of surprised that he didn't actually buy his tranquil boots.
Yeah, I was gonna ask you, like, once he base, you think he's gonna tranquil?
I think you still.
Are you
actually,
just
that's
like
a good point.
I'm close enough. Like, yeah, I'm going close enough to maybe just go blink straight up.
I see what you mean. Yeah, that's a good point. And he's definitely holding on to his gold. I mean, he's 1,200 gold away if he's able to get to his Blink Dagger slow and steady without needing to spend on the Tranquil Boots. This is definitely the right play.
I mean, the problem is this, right? Like, you just get hit a couple times. That Tranquil is going to help you get to the Blink but not dying. Top lane here, Ohio, is going to get completely gangbanged by three. And that was an easy one. I think Ohio even seen the bounty under the tower over here.
This is one way to deal with the underward.
Yeah.
Get the 2 points of Maledict. It's actually enough magic damage to burst him down.
Dire structures are fortified.
This is Dire Courier going.
Alright, Fnatic, you're gonna get some damage on this tier 1. This is what Enigma's really good at. No, I don't know exactly what he's queuing up for. The fact that Pitlord most likely— ooh, nice, nicely done here. Forces Velo out of his hiding spot. The fact that Pitlord normally gets the Vanguard allows Febby to, you know, go for a blink first.
Oh, you mean the mech?
Yeah. Sorry, did I say Vanguard?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, the mech. Febby doesn't have to buy it and he can go blink.
I was like, Vanguard? What is that going to do for him?
It's been a long day. But really Puppy has been buying Vanguard on Enigma before, so I wouldn't say that build's never been done before.
Crimson Guard is just a pretty solid teamfight item altogether, so
yeah,
I mean, it works.
Yeah, the other day I've seen Crimson doing work defending a tier 2 tower. That's the thing too now, you can pop Crimson for your buildings. Alright, this Quap's getting wrecked.
Yeah, he hasn't had an easy lane. The bounty rotation actually did enough for this Shadow Fiend. I mean, honestly, I think Shadow Fiend just wins this lane anyways. I think Quap wins for the first, like, two levels, but the moment you get the level 2 raises, I think Shadow Fiend just destroys you. Oh, that was such an aggressive blink.
Yeah. I mean, I think the bigger problem is the fact that Fnatic has a fourth lane, essentially, with Febby jungling, yet they're down by like 1,000 net worth. This is just not something you want to see. And now they're going to try to transition into a gank. Do they have dust is the question. Okay. Smoke breaks, they dust, but Raji's on the high ground, so that's it. Smoke gank fails.
And you have to remember, too, they got a tier 1 tower, and they're still behind.
Yeah. This is not a... Okay, Fade is going in. Oh, if nothing,
behind
he's...
the black hole, yeah, there's nothing, no follow. Yeah.
Try again.
Well, I mean, I don't think this is too bad for Fnatic, because like these hero could actually just sit and farm for a while and not be too bad. Mushi still needs to blink. He's not gonna go with a Helm build. Gonna go with the Try and True. And we're gonna see a Midas build out of Febby. This build really triggers me whenever my teammate goes for Impulse. Because unlike those games, there's nobody buying the mech.
I actually like this.
I think in this game is actually good. Because there's a mech buyer. He gets to like play very greedy. And honestly, Enigma is one of the better scaling heroes in the game.
I hope he hits 25 and he gets that 8 demonic conversion. That's what I want to see.
I mean, it's just actually a lot of food for like Shadow Fiend or whoever, or Bounty actually. Is under
attack. They did smoke up, but nothing really comes out of it except for a push.
I'm not sure whether they're going to get the push because here comes Velo. He's going to deliver the package.
He's got the blink dagger.
Oh, but he gets lifted immediately. They need to burst him down here. And Mushi's going to pop his ult. Velo's going to drop very low. He's going to get stunned one more time. He is going to go down. And Ohio is going to take the train out.
Oh, to kill Ohio.
Everyone's out. I mean, he's way too tanky to get killed, right?
It's not that he's too tanky to kill. It's just that they don't want to risk walking into that Ursa.
Yeah.
I think if they really wanted to trade, they could have killed him.
Also, there was a pit down, so...
Right.
Okay, well, the reveal of the Blink Dagger did absolutely nothing. Very good, fast reaction by ADTR getting that lift off.
They did kill the Enigma, at least.
Alright. But that was not the opening that they really wanted. They wanted way more than that.
Yeah, they wanted to jump in and then crush the Enigma to start it off. But like you said, that lift came up immediately.
All right, Enigma does have the Midas down. Radiance, it's not exactly the best Midas timing, all things considered.
They need Rocky to get 6, and they should use Infest Bombs with this Bounty Hunter instead. Oh, Rocky? Ooh, he revealed himself in the mid lane.
Yeah, he's gonna be dead here. Raji not respecting the tower range.
A soldier's fortune.
He was like one creep away from 6. Oh. Now that they know Slardar has the blink, they need to like mix it up. You know, you jump into the Slardar, jump into the Bounty Hunter, just really get some information. And if you jump into the Bounty Hunter, I think it's actually a pretty easy kill right now too.
Yep. I agree with that one. So, what exactly are you kind of accelerating into if you're Febby, in terms of a big item?
I actually am not too sure what would be a great pickup here. Maybe you just go into Blink Dagger, and then like, you go for a carry Enigma build. Not yeah. A carry Enigma, but you actually do a lot of damage kind of build.
I mean, is Axe a consideration this game, or you probably need BKB first before that?
Yeah, you definitely need BKB first. Like, maybe Blink, BKB, Axe, actually not bad.
Okay.
It'll do a lot of damage.
No,
all
demon.
The utility just gets picked up by a Pitlord.
Okay, hold on. Mid lane. Trying to get to Teehee. Ooh, nice quick reaction. Mushi just goes in. And the great thing about Enigma is you can transition right into a push. Velo, though, is
right
behind.
Do they want to fight this?
Ooh, blink two man crush. They go for the Rubick first, I think. Black. Oh no! Ooh. Well, Cyrenix is going to port out. Velo could easily blink out as well. Gets blink canceled for a bit. Meanwhile, though, it looks like Rocky gets found here. Mushi is going to get yet another kill. Deathboy is going to go on ADTR. Lots of random pickoff here and there. Velo now goes in again, but with Deathboy without available, they should go back. Ooh, Faded thought about the Sonic Wave. Might have actually got the kill on Velo.
Dire's top tower is under attack. I actually think that was like such a sick move from Velo and Psionics. Yeah, yeah, they just like immediately knew, oh, here comes that black hole. And that was a big air ball.
You know, I don't think they saw the Enigma before they committed. Like after they jumped in, they realized the Enigma's there. Oh, track stolen here by ADTR, but ADTR might not live to tail the tale. He's getting gone on here, and Ohio trying to save him, but the Blink Crush is gonna be there.
Wait, they might be able to kill Ohio too.
Oh, they do kill him. Now Ursa's in there. His ultimate already been committed. Keep in mind they don't have black hole. Sonic Wave is gonna take down one. That was a great exchange here by GeekFam. I do believe both of them were track kills, or at least one of them was for sure. Dire's top tower is under attack. Our Shadow Fiend does not have a bottle. That's interesting.
Well, that's interesting. He must have one.
No.
Oh, you're
Rubick,
right.
Witch Doctor just took the rune. There's no bottle in Courier.
Look at this shrine. I'll dig that. Full health.
Oh, do you know what the Chinese players call shrines?
What is it?
They call it the hot pot.
I actually like that too.
Yeah.
Hot pot.
I prefer shower. But, you know. It's all good. Alright,
yeah, Febby is queuing up that Blink Dagger. Here comes the smoke. Into the mid lane. Radiant's middle
tower is under attack. Halo, Blink Crush, that's gonna be Mushi tracked immediately. Pit is gonna be good. Mushi pops his ultimate, trying to fight his way out of there.
Oh, and
the neutral's helping out. Mushi's gonna go down regardless, but one for one trade. And now on the backline, Rocky, do they have dust? They have nothing. ADTR in a very, very dangerous position. ADTR is gonna be dead here. Oh, gets off the crush here though. Midnight Pulse doing a little bit of work against Crimson. Crimson's gonna go down. ADTR finally goes down. Ohio moving forward. Teehee just dropping raises left and right. Ohio probably gonna go down to the Rec Room. One more raise. And of course, a neutral.
Oh my
on
goodness.
It again. Neutral on a rampage
the
right now.
The most OP ancient.
Yep. Do they have more dust? They really need more detection. I feel like Febby needs better teamfight items. Yes, Blink is a teamfight item, but that's predicated on his ult, and that ult has like a billion second cooldown.
He didn't even have the Blink for that fight.
All right, call me crazy, but with something like a Necro book, might be bad here for the Enigma. I mean, you're playing against Invis heroes. There's Shadowblade up. There's Bounty Hunter on the field.
I don't really like Necro book as an investment in this patch. That's okay. Just my opinion, though. I think like the only person who really buys it is a Beastmaster. Your cooldown is that much lower, so you can actually kill people with it.
What exactly is wrong with Necro book overall? Like, not in this game, but in this patch, because you say you don't like it in this patch.
I think the investment over time is just not worth it right now. Like, the... The way the games are going right now, they just... It's like a really all-in build, I feel. It doesn't transition well into late game, and it doesn't really accomplish enough, I feel.
I think the other reason is that the alternative of a Helm of the Dominator. Oh, Roggy? He get far fine? They have no detection again. Oh, the dust is gonna find him. That should be an easy one. They're too afraid to commit. Yeah, and that's the reason why. Nice pit though. And Sonic Wave is available. It's gonna go on Velo. Velo dropping very low. And Mushi's gonna clean up. Nicely done here by Fnatic.
Getting a lot better than last game. Seems like Ursa is just Mushi's hero of choice, honestly.
Maybe that's his new hero over Quap.
Yeah.
So I was gonna say, maybe Necrobook is just not that common because of Helm. Like, it's just like a cheaper Necrobook, almost.
Oh, because like everyone groups up to fight, and I wouldn't exactly put Necrobook as a very high priority team fight item.
Sure.
Yeah, it doesn't really offer as much.
Okay. Shuriken Toss doing some work here. Now Velo moving forward. It's gonna be a two-man crush. My god, they're gonna ping out the Queen of Pain, but Queen of Pain, Invis has said, and Mushi trying to go on Psyonix, but no control here whatsoever. And now Mushi might just get control. Two-man crush again here. Mushi with the amp damage on him is gonna go down. No, Hao's gonna be dead too. He tries to rescue Mushi. Mushi, nice blink away, but they have blink again. Blink crush one more time. He's tracked up, he's open wound, and he's dead. That was Aegis, that was three kills on top of the Aegis, and they're gonna go into a tier 2. Just as he said that Fnatic's doing okay, they just imploded.
Yeah, they weren't ready to take that team fight after the in that Roshan.
Yeah.
And once again, like, Black Hole just not being able to be used. He doesn't have the items necessary to actually channel Black Hole right now.
Yep. He is working towards you. Oh, Roggy, he... Okay, well, he had the right call, but fortunately, no punish. You see someone teleporting in?
Oh, they see one TP in. This is a big kill. If they kill him, this is an easy...
All right. They're going to jump again a little bit, but now they do ping out ADTR as well. This one, though, should be easy if Slaughter wants to could blink over. Track gets stolen, but... If you kill him, that's not too bad, but no, they're not gonna kill him. ADTR survives with track, and that's huge for Fnatic.
Now they're trying to get more. Crimson, he might get caught here.
Give him the track. All right, on track.
All right, Fnatic looking fine again.
This game, look at the go graph. It's back and forth they go. So far, Febby has caught zero persons with his black hole.
But hey,
It might start here. Black hole. Dude. All right, there we go.
Right, to be fair, I don't think it was really necessary. But another kill going towards Fnatic. Oh, they just want to go in. They know it's down.
Without the threat of the black hole, Mushi in a lot of trouble. Mushi trying to man fight. Okay, gaining a ton of HP back. But once his ultimate ends, he's going to get surrounded and kited. Dead. So something you talked about,
Master's Curse.
This patch is that you think this patch is more about constant fighting, right? Then wouldn't you say a hero like Enigma, especially one that's not building mech, like be very weak in this patch?
Wait, hold that thought. ADTR gets caught up again. He definitely is gonna go down here.
And now
I'm gonna die as well.
I think so. Psyonix is gonna go right on him. He's gonna try to get his ult out, but I think the right click should be enough. One more! And again, he's just
opening
up his
tailwind. He went into the crush.
Yep, and now he pops a blade mail, but I don't think they care. That's gonna be a triple kill, three-man tracks for days. As Raji is rolling. Let's farm.
Oh my goodness. Just like that, everything just looks so bad for Fnatic. They were in such a good position.
Yep.
But I mean, like you were mentioning, the Enigma, I think Enigma is actually not that bad. You kind of have to look at it. I feel like Enigma is kind of like Legion Commander in the sense that you don't exactly pick LC for the duel. You pick LC for a lot of other different things that he has
to offer. That's the package.
Right, so Enigma, while Black Hole is obviously an incredibly powerful ultimate, is everything else he's able to do that makes him a decent hero.
But I think the difference in that comparison is that, like, things like overwhelming odds, presti attacks are useful throughout the game. And I feel like the rest of Enigma's skill set, apart from the Black Hole, like, at this stage of the game, it's just about the Black Hole, right?
I don't think so. Midnight Pulse is a pretty insane spell, if you ask me.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna say that Midnight Pulse has not been doing much either in these fights.
Yeah, I would agree with you there.
So I'm just not feeling it. Baylo's gonna find Ohio. No lifesteal inside of him, but okay. Maledict on top, Death Ward. Oh, he's dead. Oh wow, Faded's gonna teleport.
Faded into dice here. This is really bad.
Yeah, he's gonna. Yeah, okay. Mushi is gonna get controlled by Scotty. Teehee's farm. Haven't really been looking at him, but well, that's two cores going down. Three if you count Ohio. Radiant's bottom
tower is under attack. And all of a sudden, this track is just skyrocketing. Yeah. Geek Fam's farm.
This game is rolling with Wagi as he's just walking around with his teammate, killing people, being everyone's sugar daddy with track. I don't know, man.
That gold swing, it's just the last two engagements and they're 10k in gold and 6k in EXP. This is not looking good for Fnatic.
I think with Enigma on the team, you could never really give up because one Enigma Midnight Pulse Black Hole, if it's good, you could win a fight. So, I'm not going to count Fnatic out yet, but the numbers are definitely very against them. And if Geekfam has the patience to go for Aegis, then I just don't really see how it's capable of comeback. Top tower
is under attack. I think Fnatic actually needs to use smokes now. And I think they actually should blow Black Hole, even if it's one kill, and then they just run away and then try to farm safely. I think that's like the best option they have right now, because I don't think there's really any great way for them to take a 5-on-5 engagement right now.
Do you think Fnatic could hold high ground if they don't have Black Hole?
Yeah, I think they can.
Okay.
Just off the back of Midnight Pulse, it should be
Firestorm,
enough to, like,
Midnight Pulse.
Turn it. Yeah. Hit.
Okay, well. Queen trying to get the Octarine, but she's a bit away. And looks like Ursa is working towards a Bastion.
I'm actually not too big of a fan of this quap build until you actually manage to get yourself to 25. I actually think like building other items is a bit better. And then once you hit 25 and then you actually get the blade mail.
I think the most successful builds we've seen generally open up like the standard way, right? Like an orchid into an
I think Veil is fine. A lot of players actually do like
Veil's good too.
But like BKB or Scepter is actually really good.
Yeah, like right now the blade mail doesn't actually do a damn thing. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Look at it go.
There any smokes on Fnatic side? ADTR does have one, but they're not using it.
In fact, it's Raji. It's gonna scout a couple people out. Dire's
top tower. Oh, they initiate on Febby. This would be. Oh, he's pinging it out. He knows. Febby knows. Oh, Rocky. Not okay. Injured anymore. You have to be careful. Yep, he has 4 stats still.
But they're waiting. Oh no, he actually goes range of Mushi. Mushi says, okay, yeah, sure. I'll take this one. And now it's going to be Teehee going forward. ADTR is going to go back. And they get a clean pick. The question is, do they want a little bit more? Teehee does not have a BKB. They lift them up. Pit of Malice. Where's the pit? So go down one more second.
Got it.
Pit of Malice. Where's the Black Hole? Febby pops a BKB. Black Hole. And all they got was a Slaughter. Death Ward going on Febby. Febby's going to be dead. Great defensive force staff here by the Shadow Fiend to get him out. Now Mushi's being slowed up. Mushi getting bashed here. Great stun by ADTR. They got to kill Sonic. Sonic trying to run towards his team. He gets lifted back and he is dead. Moving forward is Faded. He's going on Crimson. Crimson is going to be the last one. This is going to be a team wipe. Fnatic making it happen. Don't call it comeback yet, but Fnatic showing some big signs of life, and that's off the back of Febby's Black Hole. Even though it's a one-man Black Hole, it just forced everyone away. And that was enough time here for Fnatic to get the lead in the fight.
I think that was just a lot of miscommunication from Geek Fam. I think they should have been fine if they fought together, but you know, if your Lifestealer breaks off from your Shadow Fiend and they just get isolated, it's definitely not how you want to fight.
Yeah. I mean, I think what Mushi was waiting for, like, he didn't want to jump on Raji because he was expecting to get Blink Crush immediately if he did jump on Raji. And Slaughter was also, like, expecting if he jumps in, he gets Black Hole. So nobody wanted to do anything. So then it just turned into a very chaotic team fight.
That four staff was just so unfortunate, though. Yeah. He four staff himself away and didn't expect the second one. And he just got ping ponged and
yeah,
ended up right in front of Mushi.
Mushi with his quick reaction. I was like, okay, yeah, sure. I'll take this free kill.
Alright, Geek Fam. Not afraid. Even after losing that team fight, they're going to go straight to Roshan, and this Roshan is just dead so fast.
Yep. Probably throw that on Teehee. That was a very fast reaction by Teehee, though. He would have got caught in the black hole as well. Oh, Raji? Raji's gonna get his track stolen. I mean, he's gonna be
this
okay.
This time, double force is not good for him. He's stuck.
Okay.
All right, not anymore. Third force staff.
Raji needs to protect his track. Like, this is like the third or fourth time that he's given away.
Double damage. Maybe doing the split pushing. Dire's bottom tower. Double damage, Queen of Pain. This is gonna be a free tier 2 if no one responds.
Yeah, I mean Velo's coming in, but it's gonna be a little bit too slow. And Febby's has the black hole. And he's working towards a refresher. Now I don't think he actually has enough mana pool for the refresh black hole, but it's not about casting two black holes back to back, although that can end games. It's more about casting one black hole and having access to the second one if a fight goes on. Raji? No detection.
He's gonna go for it.
And they have track.
Oh god.
Where's the black hole? It's gonna be here! The black hole is gonna catch both the cores here! And Fnatic's gonna blow them apart. Both these guys are tracked as well. Courtesy of Raji. And now, big teamfight victory. And that was after Aegis and Queen of Pain still chasing.
It might not be over yet.
Shrine?
Barky's Shrine? He's probably dead. I don't think he can run away from this.
Can he actually wear out the track? The four staffs are fast and furious, and now Crimson going for work, and Crimson gonna be dead, and now they track up Shadow Fiend too. Shadow Fiend's got the Aegis, he pops a Shadow Blade, but they have track on him. He's gonna be dead once and probably twice. Oh my god, Fnatic. Benefiting by the one by one throw of Geek Fam. The four staffs again.
Oh, they might just die in here as well.
Yeah,
he's gonna die just trying to save.
Can they track him? Can they track him? They need vision. They have no vision. How do they not have vision? I guess the team fight has been going on for a long time,
Radiant's
but
middle tower is under attack.
Fnatic now threatening to get high ground. What is this game?
I mean, this is par for the course, isn't it? I mean, we've seen this at least a couple times every day.
Fnatic going on the tier 3s, they will get it, and looks like it's going to be a retreat. Somebody forced that Pitlore away! They do! Oh, okay! One of them is caught!
Two of them is caught!
Behind! ADTR trying to make it out here. He's gonna start throwing out some track before he dies. Alright, I did not expect somebody would actually make that play, but I'm so happy that he did. Nicely done.
But that's AOE, actually so funny.
Yeah. I mean, that's the only play you make there, right? Against Ohio. Alright, well.
That's why you have to go for those big disables. Like, Velo made the right play. He knows they're gonna leave anyways. You stun all of them, and you force one out, and they don't even get to react because they're all stunned.
Yep. Well, it's not just about the stun, but also, you know, you just flabbergasted. You expect to be home.
Yep.
And then you realize you're still at the airport. Like, the taxi man has left.
I mean, people just aren't used to the timings yet so far.
Yeah. Well, you say you don't like this queen build because she's not 25 yet, but she's getting there.
The Octarine is fine. It's just the blade mail getting picked up this early is the only complaint I have. But I mean, he's making it work. He did a lot of work just now.
Yeah.
He's kept running after them and destroying everyone.
I mean, I don't think the blade mail has anything to do with that, but having the extra armor in this game is not a bad thing.
Yep. Kept them alive through. He like just laugh. Oh, Mushi, he gets caught out here. Be really careful.
Mushi's dead.
Oh, that was so close.
Oh, now Cyanex gets first hit. Bash here on Faith. Faith, where's the black hole? Baby,
huge black
again
hole.
Again here. Sonic Wave's gonna put Queen back to full HP. Welcome to the new age. Just Febby just rips up a new one. Teehee.
It's not over yet. Crimson gonna go down as well, maybe.
Faded goes right back in here, but okay, Crimson's just actually very tanky. Tanky enough to drop the casket. Okay, Queen still bounced back here, and T gets a double off of it. Oh my god. And now
three
Febby,
for three.
Febby needs to get away.
He doesn't have a TP.
He's got a blink, right?
But I mean, he doesn't have a TP. Oh, he's got a haste. Right, this is fine.
Sometimes you're good, sometimes you're lucky. Dire's middle tower. Oh, Febby.
Make Adelines. Drop Midnight Pulse. Yeah.
Oh, Febby. All right. What a cheeky play. He's going to check for runes. Oh my god, this guy.
Yeah, he's so close to his. Oh, look, one of these creeps are just following him.
He should blink up here to Midnight Pulse and farm this. Yeah, of course. I was actually joking, but he did it too. He's going to micro. Yeah, mm-hmm.
He's pretty much finished his refresher too.
Yeah. Again, he doesn't mana for back-to-back black holes, but you know, eventually he will.
I feel like if you're this rich, you should buy something else. Okay, he's. Oh, Crimson gets caught out. I feel like if you're this farmed as an Enigma, you should buy something else first. And he queues up the Octarine, which I think is actually pretty good.
I mean, it synergizes with your black hole for the cooldown. What do you think about something like Hex as well as an alternative?
I think Hex is fine too. But Octarine, he might be onto something here.
Oh.
Oh, he's not able to finish his Octarine because.
No, BKB, but he gets bashed immediately. Uh oh, and now Velo's on the run. Oh, Shadow Fiend's in there. Shadow Fiend does not have Shadow Blade anymore, so he's dead. Man, this game is just like a game of miscommunication. Everyone jumping in and out.
For more. Are they going to be able to catch anyone? They're all tracked up, so it's going to be really difficult to run after them. Call it off.
Roche is not alive yet. Maybe he needs Ghost Scepter.
Going for more. Rodgy, is he going to get caught here? Does he clip?
Yeah. Of course, track gets stolen, so ADTR will have it for the next fight.
But I was just saying, everyone's going for the Octarine.
Oh, but he made
automatically made Arcane. And then now he has two energy boosters.
Well, it'll help his refresher later on, I guess.
Oh, that must be so frustrating.
Yeah. That's why you gotta lock them boots before you buy that Octarine.
Yeah, this is definitely a lesson learned. Lock your brown boots if you're not gonna upgrade them.
Yeah. Well, who's even ahead now? Like, it's so hard to call because this game has been so back and forth.
I want to say it's about even, but if you look at the graphs, old-wise, Fnatic are up again by very little, but more importantly, they're up at like 10,000 experience, and levels are really important here. Klopp's getting close to that 25, and...
Alright, Fabi's all know... having all sorts of trouble right now trying to make his... He's going bootless because he doesn't want to put... I don't know what's happening. He sold his second energy booster.
No. He's got it down. Don't worry. Octarine is coming, and he's got the brown boot.
But I still think he wants that arcane boots. I don't think he wants to sell the second energy booster.
He's got Soul Ring and Octarine Core. I think this is fine.
Okay. All right. After the struggles, we have finally gotten the whole Octarine.
And I think at this point he just goes for Sheepstick and then Refresher.
Or like Shivas or a Ghost or whatever, right? Like, I don't think you actually need a Refresher.
Queen of Pain already has Shiva, so he doesn't need to go for that.
I just think the armor is just a value thing to have this game.
If he wants the armor, then he should get Lotus Orb instead, I believe.
Okay. Oh, he's just going in. Blink. Tracks are being thrown out here by the Rubick. Teehee comes in. Do they have detection? Nope. Oh, Mushi blinks in as his team blinks out the black hole. It's gonna be there. Febby did not BKB though. He BKB afterwards, and that means this black hole is gonna get canceled. Cyanex going to work here. Deathward, look at it go. Everyone's dying, and now ADTR on the back line here. He's gonna be dead as well. Oh, okay. Oh, good try.
Oh, that really hurts. Yeah. Febby not BKBing before his black hole really hurt them, because he hit a really good black hole. He caught the Shadow Fiend and the
Lifestealer.
Lifestealer. Well, yeah, and that's like a lot of their damage.
Yeah. Like. Well, now we're gonna need to see some buybacks because GeekFam is gonna charge through the middle. This goal graph is representing how this game is going, just up and down, back and forth. And I don't think Pitlord by himself could hold this. All right, Quap's gonna buy. Ooh, I don't know. That pit hits nothing. Firestorm hits the range creep. Looks like the Dire is gonna go back, and all they're gonna want is Aegis.
Lifestealer is getting pretty damn big too. He's got that AC finished up after the Roshan goes down. And yep. Bounty Hunter, he's queuing up for Sheepstick.
Yeah. I mean, he's about to get plus 100 damage, so if he wants to farm, he can actually start farming neutrals like super fast. And then once he gets to 25, it's a dream. Okay, Blink Crusher only getting faded. And seeing the Pitlord, they want to back off here, but faded, it's going to blink up. Black Hole's back up in 11 seconds. Ooh, Shadow Fiend going for the Bloodthorn.
Invisibility. Strength of that CDR with the Octarine. 102 second Black Hole cooldown, that's actually really good.
15% cooldown reduction with 25%.
25. Yeah.
Do you know if they stack additively?
Oh, Liv. Rocky gets caught out here.
Rocky is...
Oh, he's gonna make it.
Yeah, he is. And now, nice BKB by Mushi. And now he's gonna turn to Cyanix, who's gonna bash who? Everyone's standing there, and so is Febby. But Febby gets off the black hole. And now everyone's stuck in the toilet. And the toilet, there's only a one way out, and he's dead. Meanwhile,
But they have to kill him again.
Yeah, it looks like they will be, though. T's gonna get control as well. Mushi applying the damage. GeekFam, Cyanix going to work here. Mushi getting controlled by the Basher. The Force Staff does not get him back here. And the Aegis winning fight for now. Cyanix still going in. Febby applying the Maleficent here. Traxxas applying an ADTR.
Oh, Mushi buys back.
Mushi buys back, but he needs to get back into this fight. Rogi is gonna provide the trip home here for the Lifestealer. I think all things considered, that was a good victory here for GeekFam.
Force yeah, I mean, Mushi, hole, Mushi bought buyback. Back.
Yeah.
I mean, they didn't force off the buyback. Mushi just bought back, assuming the team fight would go on a little longer. But just like that, they just disengage and that ends the team fight.
Yep. I know you were laughing at the Octarine Midas build, but look, Febby's farm is ridiculous now.
Okay, to be fair, he's not a void either.
Yeah. I mean, AoE crowd control. Either way, similar. And we're approaching 25. So your dream of plus 8 demonic conversion is a possibility.
Febby gets caught out again. BKB? He's not gonna make it. Bloodthorn Shadow Fiend.
Yeah.
This just like completely annihilates the Quap, I think.
Quap needs like Yules.
He's going for Lincolns right now.
Okay. Not bad. I mean, once he gets 25, like... If you're silenced, you just pop Blade Mail, right? Like, does that fix this, the problem?
Well, first of all, he needs to be 25.
Yeah, he's almost there. Halo, okay, they're gonna go with ADTR, ADTR, nice defensive force app.
Oh, they didn't catch out Teehee!
Wait, where's he?
Couldn't catch out Teehee. They force a buyback on Febby and no one's dead. They need to catch someone here.
Okay, Queen's going for nobody. Actually, GeekFam wants to fight this. I mean, if they can get Febby first. Febby's position.
If they kill Febby, this is gonna be really bad.
Oh, the force staff goes on the high ground, but TV's gonna get him. That's a dieback on Febby, and now Queen of Pain gonna get locked down. The death.
Oh, this cask is just destroying them.
Left and right. The trip home, only one will make it out there. Oh, wait. And they out. But still, that's three dead. Febby, no buyback. The creep wave is behind. And I don't know, Fnatic needs to make some sort of next level hold. Queen of Pain, very close to 25. Kench, like, is it home? I don't know.
He's running out bottom lane. He wants his 25. Like, he really needs it. But it might be
Might be too late.
It might be too late, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if he's gonna get there in time. Pops a Shiva. Okay, that's 25. TP back now, man. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. How many lanes of racks can they give up and still have a shot in this game? Two?
Two.
Okay, well, one down. Two is gonna be down. Queen, is Queen back soon?
They're not gonna back because she can't defend without the rest of their team, so she might as well just push out the lanes.
Can they be Megas? Because it's looking like it soon.
Well, I mean, if you don't defend this, you're gonna lose the game. So they have to buy as much time as they can, then take this fight. They're just gonna have to go. They can't wait any longer.
Track being sold and Queen is in here. Screen Song 25 here. Let's the Sonic Wave rip, and that's gonna be Megas. It seems like TT's gonna focus on the Rubick on the back line. Queen pops the Shiva, pops the Blade Mail, because HP's getting back, but not fast enough. He blinks away.
Ooh, he's 30 life.
Oh, Blink crushed by Velos. And that is gonna be it. That's gonna be Mega Creeps. Okay, Febby threatening the black hole, but no one's here. And now BKB's down. I think they could hold Mega Creeps.
They can definitely hold Mega Creeps.
Yeah. Oh, the Range Racks.
I don't think a Range Rack means anything right now.
I agree.
Apart from a couple of 100 of gold for the team, it doesn't really mean too much.
Yeah.
No Queen of Pain. They're just marching down mid. They're gonna all in here. I am pretty sure this is what's gonna happen.
I don't think they go all in at all.
Well, they have a Dark Rift to fall back on if they change their minds.
Well, seeing how everyone has been dying so fast, I'm not sure. Ooh, the late game Rocky switch with the death. Oh boy, he's dead. All right, time to fall back, boys. Fall back.
He didn't go for 100 damage. He went for 8% spell amp.
What? What are you spell amping? Your shuriken toss?
I feel the same way. I think 100 damage is actually worth it.
I'm not impressed.
He needs that Magnum Scepter for it to be worthwhile.
Yeah. Febby's gonna get caught here. His team is not nearby, but Febby might just need to pop a BKB and just leg it. Oh, but the Hex? That's
it's buying you enough time, enough team, enough first team. Oh, the Dark Rift comes out immediately.
The triple! Yo, no! He got forced out!
Oh my goodness, that play again.
Velo! And that's it, right? Like, this is actually it without the Enigma Black Hole.
I believe this is it. And you still don't have your Queen of Pain. A couple more seconds. Alright, this is it. The final hold.
What hold? Quap's gonna blink in. She needs to reserve Sonic Wave after she takes damage. She's full HP right now though, but okay, they're gonna focus on Rocky. Rocky's gonna get fourth tap away, and Psyonix, he sees the eyes on the prize, man, just goes for the building here. Mushi pops the ultimate Sonic Wave, doing a little bit of damage here. They're gonna focus on Velo. Velo's gonna be dead. It looks like they're actually holding. Teehee's gonna now
but
focus.
The throne is gonna go down. You have
okay.
to stop them from hitting it.
Focus
just hitting it.
Mushi. Okay, nice defensive shotgun here, but Teehee is gonna go down here. Ohio's in there, and Psyonix, is he right clicking the building? Looks like he is, and the nobody's actually
gonna hit him.
Okay, Blink Crush by AVTR, they lift him up! They hold! I don't know how he got the HP back, and he's gonna kill the damn throne. He had cheese in that fight.
No, he just infested a creep and popped
out. Okay, he just got a whole bunch of HP back. Holy shit, guys.